attention. So we are going to be into another topic, which is customers' ethics. So take into account your customers are going to be a slightly different. So a customer buys if what you offer is worth it. So you're not going probably to sell products, though some of you are already selling products, and that's good, gives you a good training, but probably you have to sell yourself, and what is to sell yourself? The skills that you have. Yes. So nowadays, more than ever, the customer is the key. Why? Because you go into the internet and then you find the reviews of people who have used the product, or people who grades the lecturers, or grades the secretaries, or grades you. Anything you put now in Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, eventually is going to be checked by people who are interested in employing you. So it's very important you do the things right, even from now. Oh boy, we have problems with sound again.
People don't buy whole inch dress, they buy quarter inch holes. And here's another one. In the factory, we make cosmetics. In the drugstore, we sell hope. For both of these quotations, the underlying idea is that the goal of marketing is to first identify and then satisfy consumer needs and wants. And that's where the study of consumer behavior and microeconomics can be so valuable.
So what have you got about it? Let's start here. Yes? Okay, identify and satisfy. What happens if you identify and don't satisfy?
You don't sell.
So one thing is to identify, the other thing is to make the product in a way that you satisfy the wants or the needs. What is the difference between wants and needs?
Needs are... I can't get the words.
Needs are basic, wants are luxuries.
So you don't need them to survive, you don't need them for basic needs. So the important thing in production is to identify and satisfy the needs of the customer. So first to identify which are the customers, the potential customers, that is called differentiation, because you are different from your grandparents and your parents, and men are different from women. So if you make a product for each of them, you sell, or you make a product that fulfills all of them. Now, customer ethics is two ways. We have rights and as customers, and we have duties as well. It's always a double process. Wherever we have a right, there is a duty. Wherever there is a duty, there is a right for somebody else. And so customer protection, but we as consumers, we have to try to make the world sustainable. That means that we have to reuse, reduce, and recycle if we can. So reuse is to use it again as much as we can. So China cups are better than paper cups because they are reusable. But syringes are dangerous to reuse, because you can get HIV or any other disease if they are not properly cleaned. Reduce is not consume much more than we need, not to hoard things that we don't need, even they are nice. And then recycle is to reprocess the things. So, now in your notebook, three most important customer rights. So what are our most important rights and what are more important duties? Forgetting about reducing, recycling. In teams of two, so you can get more accurate version. What are our rights and customers, the most important rights? Equality. Let me continue. Have you done?
All right. I'll save products.
Yeah, products.
Safety.
Safety is one. The other two? Not yet. Information of the product, okay. Indications and counterindications, what else? Alternatives to choose from in the shop, yes. The third one? Quality. Okay. What is advertised should be given. Let's see. Try to be heard, yes. To choose, yeah? And to be informed. Okay, you cannot choose if you are not informed, yes? Sorry? Transparency is too general. Yeah, that has been said. But that is general, that is not the only consumers. No discrimination of consumers. The other one has been said. Okay. Last one for consumer rights.
Accessing credit rights.
Fairly priced, yes. That's
you. Who's the trustee for consumption?
Fit for consumption. Safe for consumption, safety for consumption. Quality, okay. Now, duties of the consumer. Sorry, let's see, somebody who has not got, haven't got the data.
It has been
respect who? The owners, okay. Pay up. Concerned environment, okay. Anybody else? Let's see, somebody who hasn't got it. Given feedback, okay, that's one. Read the terms or conditions. The third one. Be respectful has been said. Not discriminatory on the shops that you go. Okay. Yeah, you cannot go to this waiter instead of the other. Uh-huh. Okay.
To speak up if this is something
wrong. That's what she has said, the feedback. Somebody else, let's see. Sorry?
Ethical, but that's very general. We have all to be ethical. When you leave a change to the planet, they have been done. Be loyal and feedback. Okay. So these are the things.
I have a question.
Yeah.
Can a customer have a duty to be informed?
No, that is a right.
Right to be informed.
Yes.
But it's up to you to get informed.
And you have the duty to be informed as well. Yeah. Okay. Question. Sorry.
And loyal. You have a duty to be loyal.
Not necessarily.
It's a choice.
Not necessarily. Unless you have signed a contract with them. So, because customer thing is sometimes are broken in a very funny way. Who has not been ever in a shop or in a supermarket? who has never been in a supermarket or in a shop?
Binge.
Binge, yeah, binge. Binge some goods, not pay for them.
Connie, which type of child are you, country? We used to steal chocolate from the mat. No, you've never stolen from something from school. We used to steal chocolate.
Supermarkets are not only a beehive of activity, but where the shoppers go to shoppers and just about everyone coming in and getting out. And a casual observation will never reveal how much of your daily intentions of all those in there are. It was the same for these two women at the commercial supermarket in German town. They worked here in the responsible by the shoppers, but they had other intentions, shoplifting. One was over a hour and with another roll of tissue, making the packet in a part of the body that would raise very little suspicion. And they provided a frantically of candles, which were on the air at 2 o'clock at dinner, as they attempted to walk out to the supermarket in their boots.
Ni sana kwa kwa Tanzania mtu anaweza ina mstari wa kutafuta ni
customers can cheat is to claim for things that they have not the right to. So insurances, maybe for insurances, burning your shop when you want to change the location, so there is insurance premium, sorry, not a premium, but a claim, asking for medicines that you are not going to use but you're going to sell. All these type of things is breaking the agreement and taking advantage of those who provide the services. So fraudulent returns of merchandise, you buy something, then you get something spoiled somewhere else, and then you return it and you want the money back. So in that way you keep the goods and you recover your money. Okay, so for exchange of merchandise, providing false information either to the bank or to financial institutions, that is cheating as well, you're not giving the right information, or pirating digital content, pirating movies, pirating music, pirating anything. So the punishment claims, we have already said about it, and then improper disposal, leaving things in trash, and the trash around. And you are good to clean the tables when you use the gazebos or the student center or the library, so you don't leave the things in a way that other people will find it difficult to enjoy a meal or a working. So then one of the things that we have is to, as she said, know our consumer rights. Because if we don't know, we will not claim them. Yes? You can claim the four shillings, and you have to wait until somebody pays.
No, I'm asking because if I had the balance,
they are breaking the agreement. You don't want the streets. They give you an opportunity. What you can do is to return the things to the shelf or leave them there and say, sorry, I'm not interested. And then you go walk away because they don't have. So they have lost the consumer. You can accept it, you cannot accept it. They are not forcing you. So it's not a bad practice. then you have said this to complain when the quality of the product is not good, and then and you can return it. And you have to have the right of returning defective goods. If you don't accept them, then that is a bad shock, and you can claim. And you can report it, you can put it in Facebook, they immediately, they usually, directly respond to it. Yes?
So, in case as well, you buy something and and they tell you you don't have return policy, but whatever you buy is counter.
Then you go to the police, or you go to the special department for counterfeit goods.
So, is that a violation?
It's a violation, because you are buying something from this brand that you think that is made in Germany and it's made in China. So you say, no, you have cheated me. And that is not the agreement that I have with you. Yes?
You can say that you said that you're not satisfied with the returning and some complete things are supposed to be done. But for example, let's say you buy something electronic, let's say like a TV. And you take it to your house and then it burns in your house. But the problem is when you watch it from the shop, it's fine. But when you take it home, you watch it for like 2 hours and 20 minutes. So how is that the shop's problem?
No, then you have to report it and you have to return it. Then if you are the cause, because you imagine that it's 110 volts and you put in 250, you have cooked it. But you are responsible. If it is a defect of the product, then they have to return it. So consumer duty is to read carefully instructions. As you see now, in the internet you have many places in which people
On the front of us here, you can see that there are some building lights. These give an indication of when the scooter is balanced. And then across here, you'll see the wheels. They've got a nice rubber texture, rubber feel to it. Then you'll see on the front right here, right there, there are some LED indicators for battery level, as far as I know. So the self-balancing scooter comes with some pressure-sensitive pads.
So you see, you have plenty of YouTube videos on anything you want to buy now, and then you have reviews. Some of the reviews are paid for, okay? And some of the people who do it because they are part of the company, or they are interested in the company, or they want to be nice with the company. So one review doesn't make, or several reviews doesn't make. You have to really trust the people who are doing the review, or do it. So then you have the right to be informed in the language that you buy. So if you buy something in Kenya, you expect it to be in English, not in Chinese. Yes?
But is this a right or a duty?
Both things. Both things. Because if you say, well, I bought this thinking of, you have to do due diligence. So when you buy a house, you check. And sometimes you have to tap on the tiles to see if the tiles have been properly placed. If not, they will start broken in a year's time. So you have to do due diligence. But you have to have the information in the language that you're buying. So if you're buying in Kenya, you can demand that it's Hindi or English, the two official languages. Because if it is in Chinese, or badly translated Chinese, then you will maybe not satisfy. So the ethical attitude of the consumer could be productive. We consume what can produce, what we need to produce, or what we need to be able to enjoy or satisfy our needs. The wants is more aleatory. Then consumerist is the ones that want things that interest gratification, and they cannot stop buying. They have to visit the mall every week and buy something. Because what they have. And then the environmental consumption is to try among the things that I can choose, the one that is longer lasting, I can recycle.
Like a plate of things, 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 like a plate of things.
think that that's in the first place. Yes, there's a demand for it, but the demand is not because of maybe it's a free system.
Yeah, they are companies, they have to create the needs, they have to offer the products that people are wanting. So if you are convinced that looking whitish is more attractive than looking blackish, that's your problem. You can sell yourself in a different way. Fashion is a very tricky aspect. Fashion is good if it improves us. It's not good if we become dependent on it, and then somebody decides how to be dressed. Well, so yes.
So there is people who sell electronic items, and some of them they'll tell you, you just look at it. If you open it, you have to buy it.
Yeah.
So isn't that is that infringing on our right, or they are protecting themselves?
Both things. Because if you open it, now the resale value is practically nothing. So for example, you buy a Mercedes, you want to sell it the following day, and the value is 30% of what you have bought. So you have to protect yourself. So it's both ways. So you have to trust the person whom you are buying, and then open it. And that is a condition to return things. If you don't open it, say sorry, I made a mistake, they you return it and there is no problem. Yes? Yeah, there are guidelines. But usually the market is the best guideline. Okay, we are seeing this. What has happened?
Going on.
They try to sell you that thing. So ethical issue regarding marketing now. So what is marketing? Marketing is to create a market for the product that you have. So your product is yourselves, because you are not producing things normally. So unless you write novels, and then you want to market the novel, but when you're going to market your services, international relationships, or HR, management, or secretarial services, or whatever. So you have to know what are the things that work in the market. So in market money, the product policy, so you have safety number one. So if I sell a toy that is, it can be swallowed by my baby, that's bad news. I had a friend that had a problem, and he had to be taken. A small piece went into the lungs, so they have to take it to the hospital and operate on it. So safety is very important in children's toys, for example. Fitness for purpose. So I have to make something that really solves the need of the people. So we have a right to safe and efficacious products. So we will see. Then marketing communication. So deception. What is deception? To exaggerate, for example, the goodness of a product. Or to say this is going to make you less obese, you have to put the cream, and then 2 kilos disappear. That's deception. Misleading claims. You have fake advertising. You go to the internet, you have plenty of them. Intrusiveness. What is intrusiveness? They come to your home, they knock, they want to sell, they put the food so that you cannot close the door, and they keep on pestering you. Or they call to your phone every now and then. Or in the mobile, you're getting SMS. That is intrusion. Yes?
How is it being
intrusion?
Because they say it's intrusion.
Sorry?
How is
it being intrusion? Being deception is to give something which is not there. Misleading claims is to exaggerate the goodness of the project. Promotion of materialism that is to make you to consume, 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 yeah? To push you to consume continuously. Creation of artificial ones, the reaching that we're mentioning, could be one of the things, perpetuating dissatisfaction. Okay? So that there is a small problem that you have to go and to the shop, so that they charge it. And it happens again, and it happens again. It's a small thing, but you have to go every time that. Reinforcing stereotypes. Again, teaching could be one of the examples that you have to be clean, that you have to be whitish, yeah, that you have to have this type of hair. So we have the right of privacy that is broken, and the right of honest and fair communications. Pricing, excessive pricing, and they are charging 5 times the cost for production and the maintenance, and research and maintenance. Well, this is very, very difficult. Price fixing is the most normal. So every petrol station charges the same. Then you say, well, and they overcharge. Or all the communication, the wire communication companies charge the same.
Right by the cashier. So there are people who
the distribution, or they pay the shop for stocking this product and no other product. So they get a cut. Give some bribes, this is very normal. Right? So if you want to you have a good relationship with the shop, because on Christmas you get a bonus, or you get a bonus. So the slotting fees is what I have said. And the marketing strategy, targeting the vulnerable. So older people usually have a lot of money, but they cannot reason well. So they are the target for mobiles, for tablets, for computers, for packages. So you go to children and to elderly people. So Facebook now is having a problem because they were accepting money from children using the credit card of the parents. And they didn't say anything. So that is standing in the vulnerable consumers. And consumer expression is what you say, discrimination. You have already mentioned that one. So business is an organization, you know it very well, and the most important thing is the consumers, if you want to have good business. So consumers are the purpose of the business. Yes, there you are.
Another question.
Yeah.
What's the thin line between having a defined market niche and consumer discrimination?
Consumer discrimination is that you don't sell. Consumer targeting is that you target a particular group, but this doesn't exclude anybody. So that I target you for this product doesn't mean that the grandmother can come and buy it. Not discriminating, but my advertising is to the main people who are going to benefit from this product.
I guess I will try to
use it and I'm not excessively priced at the places. It's very thin line, and it depends a lot on professions and marketing. Professions and the goods that you are producing. For example, from the verticals, can take 10 years research and development, many people doing it. And there are other things that a Kyoto will do it like that. So the pharmaceuticals have to have a huge profit market, and the Kyoto can be very
good.
Yeah, if you are overpriced, you're out of the market. Yeah, you can start a price war, but that could be good for the consumer. The price war on Telcom and Airtel and Safaricom is good for us.
You think that the price is supposed to be according to the market? For example, I sell my product in Manager's cheeks to the street that somebody else sells. So my rent and that rent is not the same. So how is it that my price is supposed to be rent?
No, your price has to be higher. That's why in airports, the prices are very high, so they have to pay a huge rent, and because they have the main consumers as well. So the most important people to take care of are the consumers. So that is the definition of marketing, to get the market for your product or service. They're going to provide mainly services, so you have to be especially nice. You are the product. Now, there are many ways of breaking the consumer lines. Look at this one. Let's see if you can spot what happens.
Testing. Providing biased advice
find a solution, like if you're going to be a consultant for humanitarian people. So you give biased advice, you support one group in the world. Yeah. So being biased, it can be a lie. Your turn. Reselling many spoiled products can also work, but just in case you have a side hustle for a business. You can say stealing a research, like if you're a consultant and you're meant to, or maybe you're a researcher and you're meant to research on something that will help organization, so you plagiarize the whole research and it doesn't help you.
And more valuable even the feedback from your parents, because the administrators take care of that. The lecturers, we may not have influence in these things, but you are powerful and your parents are even more powerful. So a couple of letters from parents are very, very powerful. So you got the point.
So he's telling us to love and respect, right? So you can get motivation.
So speak up.
If you want.
Now this is another one of counter things that you have mentioned.
We are like learning English. This is the technology. Counterfeit goods or false versions of products may cost the government of Kenya up to $1 billion each year. The counterfeit goods also hurt business owners who find it hard to keep customers. Now, information technology is being used to stop the problem. Jemima Mwafigu is a 34-year-old businesswoman who sells products like perfume and cologne. She found it hard to keep customers because of counterfeit goods. Ms. Mwafigu says her business has improved since she began using a smartphone application called Barcode Scanner. The app checks to make sure the products are real. With this app, she says, she can check the barcode of each perfume. Right away, she gets the manufacturer and expiration dates, and she knows if it is a true product. She says it gives her confidence in selling to her customers. In 2010, Kenya created the Anti-Counterfeit Agency, or ACA, to fight against illegal trade. The ACA has successfully asked government officials for stronger punishments for counterfeiters. the ACA says it is trying to stay ahead of the people making counterfeit goods. The agency is testing another program called All Virtuous. The application is another way to follow. The International Chamber of Commerce is a global business organization. It says the value of counterfeit goods produced around the world is expected to be more than $1 trillion
this year.
why was she reading so slowly?
Because she's a poor learner of English. So that's why she is talking slowly. Anyway, you are faster than that. Now, in Spain, there was a counterfeit lady. You went for the phone first and then the postcode with your permission. Please. Some people started selling oil, very cheap, olive oil, they say. And then 1 year after, then the doctors started finding people who were sick, very sick, and some three of them died, and they didn't know the cause. So they started analyzing what was common among them. And what was common among them is that they were buying this olive oil, fake olive oil, from street vendors. So no guarantee, no brand, no consumer advertising, not sold in the shops. So they faced the problem, and then there were some people that were mixing industrial oil with olive oil. And then that destroyed the brain of the people. So that's one of the things. So when you buy something that is on the street, you are taking a risk. You're taking a risk because there is nobody behind that can guarantee that it is done. So we have now the Kenya Bureau of Standards that you have to put a sticker. But the stickers can be counterfeited as well, so there is no much guarantee on that. Or they have both skin in the market. So who should protect the consumer? So some people say the government. And in part it's true, but some people have distrust the government involved. Why? Because they are inefficient, because they can be corrupted, and you can buy the stickers at the price. So if you have an honest and efficient government, the government clearly has to do that. But we have to be aware that sometimes that doesn't work. So there is a second thing that is the consumer activism. So consumers are the ones who protect themselves and protect other consumers. So in many countries, you have magazines that are consumer guides. And they analyze, they scrutinize, they say, for example, in matches, boxes of matches, they usually say 40 sticks. So in this place, in these magazines, for example, they analyze all the matches that are sold and they say this one regularly has 32 matches instead of 40. These sometimes even put 41 matches. So you can choose the brand according to the quality that they are giving. They analyze beauty products, they analyze food, they analyze those things. We don't have that here, but now in the internet, again, one has to be careful which is the source that is reviewing the product, but you get many reviews. And most of the advertising now is done through the internet.